Gonna have to swap games really quick. And again, it does this. There's something wrong with my copy of Sword. I just know it. Always does this. Some dust in here, maybe? That's probably what it is. But it only has this issue with Sword, so it might just be the cartridge. There it is. I just need to make sure certain Pokemon are no longer on the main team here and pop them onto the side. And so it begins. The maintenance should be over by now. There we go. Bunch of oldies and goodies. And where is my shiny Snivy I have? Oh, it was literally in the first box of page 2. I'm dumb like that. I have a special trap inch. I think I did. That's a Flygon. Filter, Pokemon species, F, Flygon. Really? How about the Trapinch? This one's almost maxed. Friend Ball in 2015. Could you get the Friend Ball? See why it wouldn't be possible. So this one's just one bottle cap away from having top stats. It already has a good nature. Maybe this is something I got through a wonder trade? I'm not certain. I don't quite remember it. But you know, why not? I'm going to take everything I possibly can and see how much I can shove into Scarlet and Violet. This ought to also really clear up my, like, fill up my Pokedex. Alright, it's Hoodwink. Nice. You got the pink axolotl and everything, huh? Wait a minute. Duh. Why wasn't I doing this? Frickin' hell, why didn't I do this? And then, once I have all this filled up, I'll try to just fit as much as I can onto Scarlet and Violet. If I'm lucky, I'll still have more spaces to unlock. I'm not certain how much room I have, though. But all things considered, I'll probably just store stuff between the two. Swap out some of my full boxes for full boxes here of other stuff. Or at least what I can get in there, you know? Sweet! Come on. I am making a big change in my data, so yeah. Right, you're not the special one. Okay, cool. You gotta go in here. Yep, we need to max up your stuff. You go and whip. Good thing I checked for their name. This is the Aventazard. A Jolly Kilowattrel that I have. Jolly's not a good nature for it. Shimano. Yeah, I'm just checking to make sure that you, I gave a silly name to as well. Yeah, okay, that works. Thank you. What? No, Furrowthorn? Fuck you. Genuinely, fuck you. Goddamn. You there. Duraludon. Yeah, Wartortle. No Aerodactyl? Oh, come on. They're just anti-fun at this point. Toxtricity is cool. Litwick. Dangerous! Oh, that's funny. No, Ultra Beast. They're just anti-fun, damn. None of you. I'll put you in here to get you out of the way. I don't know if I had a Porygon 2 already. Just get that out of the way. Weed! You were my starter in 5th gen. Get over here, you. I guess I'll throw in an M-board just to add that to the decks. Chikorita. Did I already put a Froakie in? Yes, I did. It's the boys! Now I got a Chimchar in there. A Electivire, finish off that. Same with you two idiots. That matters there, but not here. That's an alpha. Purple Minior. I definitely already had Duat. It'd be nice if it had a little marking that said, like it has the no other things and like other information like that. It would be nice if it had one that marked that it's not in the Pokedex of this game yet. Because right now I'm just guessing. Ice. Yeah, I'll have a shiny Umbreon. Hell yeah, I'll raise that for the battle. Right, I remember what it is now. This is for specifically legendaries. This is for paradoxes. But there are paradox legendaries as well, which go into the legendary section because that's an override on that. Crozma. Volcanion. Yeah. That'll work for me. Raikou anywhere? We have Raikou anywhere? That's my battle ready, level 100, Uxie. Well, I got what I really wanted. Where's the Snivy I put in here? I know I put a Snivy in here just now. Where's the Snivy? Is it still in here? Please tell me it's not still in here. There it is. Okay, I just wanted to make sure. I'll have to give you your hidden ability. Yeah. This works for me. Okay. Cool. And now, let's see how much it updated. I have two of them he'll reward me for filling up the Pokedex. There's only now I can focus on doing. Aha! Wait a freaking minute. Those are pictures from within the Great Crater. Okay. So there's certainly more stuff going on than what I know so far. What kind of stat growth is that? I guess I'll have Celine then. You, I need to fix. I need an ability patch to fix you. That's not good. Well, now that that's partly done. I have a feeling I'm going to want to have to go ahead down back to Great Crater of Area Zero, but not all the way down. No, I should go to that secret spot with the weird emblem on the ground, because that, I bet, has something going on now. Oh, right. Oh, that's a lot of those. Alright, that's a lot of those. Spend for an accessory for a certain Pokemon. I forget what. Oh, wait, you used that to make Galarian Slowking, right? Alright. Now I'll just buy a whole shit ton of carbos. Perfect. Excellent. Turns only just an inflated sense of pride. It takes a while for Servine to be able to cooperate with other Pokemon. You just know! This one's a huge pain in the ass then. This one needs to improve everything. Like, oh my god, that's terrible. What TMs can you learn? You can learn a few. Doesn't learn much in the way of other types of moves. So I'd have to use Terra Blast to give it something a bit out of the ordinary, unless it has a wider move pool after evolution. I plan on using it as a full-on speed attacker. Let's head back here. We're gonna go to the school store and buy stuff using all the BP I saved up. Since that's gonna make it easier to get attack stuff and everything like that, I hope. Can I purchase ability patches? I can only buy so many. Then I don't have to worry about you. Except for bottle caps. I'm gonna get a lot of bottle caps for you. I'm pretty sure I can purchase those now, so I'll worry about that after your EVs are all set. You are practically all good to go. So I'll use one Volokype on you after you leveled up a bit, but I'm curious how I should build you. So, let's look up Flygon's stats. Is everywhere except for attack and speed, which are both 100. So it's really the most evened out one there is. It's got a significant enough move pool, so that's not really an issue. And it seems no one's checked certain other stuff or... No one's updated its listing of moves that I can learn for Generation 9. Which means I'll be doing a bit of testing. But... Another thing I can't figure out. It'll take me as one of these. Earthquake. Let's go. This screen is better than the evolving in-world screen. Even if it just suddenly says, welcome right there. Yes, welcome to your new stage of evolution. You are now Vibrava. Strange ultrasonic waves by vigorously vibrating its wings. After making its prey faint, it dissolves the prey with its digestive juices. Oh, so it just... Oh. Creepy. Cool. I'll see what Smogon's done with it in the latest setup. There's not likely a set now, but I'll be able to see what some various ideas are. No move sets currently available. And Sword and Shield. Flygon's sheer versatility, excellent defense, typing, and ability, and offensive potential make it one of RU's best offensive electric immune Pokemon. A top contender that can fit on many different teams, Dragon Dance Flygon is an immense threat that can sit up against common Pokemon like Raikou. A choice band set gives more immediate wall breaking potential. Interesting. Defog set with Earthquake, Defog, Roost, and Toxic. Earthquake, U-turn, Stone Edge, Outrage, Toxic. Well, my Opera GX on the phone really does not like smogon.com, but now I can see what the general way people use it is. It's somewhat bulky, with its only major weakness being ice and other dragons and fairies. But now that it can be terrestrialized, I can take away its weaknesses. And it has significant stats due to its well-roundedness. It's a neutral game champ now. And I'm gonna show it off that way. Thunder Punch. Alright, so with a max HP of 364 at 100, and a max speed of 328 at 100, yep, it's topping 300s in those two stats. Topping 300 in its attack, and getting close to 300, it's topping in 280 maxes for all of its other stats. So which the best stats do I want to pick? I probably want to go with a max speed, max attack. But I don't need max speed, max attack if I Dragon Dance. There we are. Do I want to take a little bit out of its speed and attacks and some dragon dancing in order to put a bit more into its HP so it can better tank hits? That's my question. Or would that not matter unless I have a significant margin involved? I can now see its stats unabided in the 150 range, which is pretty cool. With no investment, it has 100 defense and 100 special defense, making it respectively tanky. That is a pretty good setup. I'll have to make you Terra Electric ASAP. Yeah, it's got pretty good mid-range bulk. I still definitely want to put a bit of investment in health. How much do I want to put in? It has to end up as a multiple of 4 in order to not waste any points. I'll still have 2 left over that won't do anything though. Those are the buffer room. So if I go about it as, let's see, if I have 40 EVs, I have a total of 10 additional health. Which isn't really a lot. 10 additional health at level 100. So if I really want to work it out, I'll probably want to go for at least 20. So I'll need 80. So if I get 8 HP ups, then I can put the rest into speed and attack. Evenly. Goal is to terrestrialize, dragon dance, and then sweep in with that. Can't be paralyzed. Really, only burning could be an issue. Okay, so I put 8 of these into them, then 20 each of the others into them, and that should work. That ought to do it. And he's not even maxed yet. You only need just enough speed, but you always want more attack. So I can still pump 30 more of these. And now he's finished. All I need to do is put a bottle cap into his health. And I'll give him a few more points. And then I'll be almost battle ready. Yeah, almost battle ready. Can't wait, can't wait, can't wait. Now, how many electric Terra Shards do I have? 22, I need to fix that. Alright, we got this. All I need to do is get plenty of shards. I'm 28 down. Get that many more, and I'm golden. A yawn, huh? those two being burned sucks, but, you know. Oh, who's cool and all, but it's really not doing much for you. Alright, Terrestrialize, followed by Earth Power. Yep, I'll make it work. I have two boosts, I have type effectiveness, and you've reduced your special defense. So this should hurt really hard. Sweet. And we're good. Let's see how many we get. Two, five. I got eight. That means I need 20 more. Four squawk abilities to lift up a taxi though, Jesus Christ. In his current state, he would be good for it. I just need to increase his level. Tackles the target while exhibiting overwhelming menace. This may also make the target flinch. Well, now he's slightly above the recommended level. Okay. Let's see if we can make it work. Open with a dragon dance, then earthquake, 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 earthquake. You're only 2 times weak to it now instead of being 4 times weak to ground. Right. Resist everything. That just increased my special defense. How dare you? Wow, how does this thing just constantly causing poison? That don't matter anymore. Watch it use Mortal Spin and poison me again. Is it just me or is that thing ticking down faster than usual? Why am I seeing this animation? Yeah, I'm aware. Oh, thank goodness. All right. Thankfully, I had just about everything I needed. Ooh, a bottle cap. Nice. Very nice. Now let's see how many we have. Six more. Never seems to be enough electric type, or really just the type I'm looking for. Hopefully that one over there is going to be a Lobby. Now I can just crash through it. Before I finish off tonight, I want to have this Flygon ready to go. These attacks, everything with a destructive power of a terrible explosive sound. Nah. Yep, this'll work. All right. Winding down, this is probably gonna end up being the last battle of the night. Oh, we are getting a lot done. That's what I like about it. So much done. It's gonna run through all of its specialty things simply because I got it down that low. I did so much before it could even terrestrialize. All right, works for me. I steal the accordion bug's Terra, and we're good. So four. How many more did I need? Six total? So that means I probably need two more, right? Yep, still need two more. I wonder what turrets are gonna make it, though. That will be a curiosity. But no, I need that electric, so let's see if we can find one more. Looks like we're gonna be able to pull it off. Whatever level that one is, it'll hopefully be enough. As long as everything here isn't level 5. Yeah, if the ground's flat enough, ground travels faster. Oh, well. I'm just gonna bully this thing. Half of its stab moves will not be able to hurt me. So, oops. Excellent. Oh yeah. We're just gonna be mean. And fell straight down. Cool. What? You're not gonna use the ground type move? Force terrestrialize. Yeah, buddy. Boom. Not even that strong, man. I don't think I have one of you. Here, just get in the ball. Make it easy. The E-Terra shards I needed. Yeah. Yeah. Victory. Yeah. This makes you want to celebrate with an M&M. Heart ball. Alright. Time for a very shocking sand spirit. And tomorrow I'll try out doing some battling with my fun new buddies. Of course, I am going to have to get an ability patch for my Survivines, so they're going to have to be on the back burner for a bit. I can't change your nickname? Well, that's unfortunate, but I can change yours. A Flygon that's Terra Electric with Thunder Punch. And is somewhat tanky and has Dragon Dance. Let's go down to the trivia section. Both known as the Mystic Pokemon in English and Spirit Pokemon in Japanese, because they share categories with Zatu. Justice for Flygon. I have an idea. Mega. Synonyms. Mega is typically used to refer to size. Colossal, considerable, enormous, gigantic, humongous, monumental, sizable, tremendous, vast, whopping, strong mass, astronomic. Weak matches, epic, ginormous, jumbo, mammoth, massive, monster, prodigious, very big, very large. Adjective as in imposing. Adjective as in astronomical. As an adjective, as in imposing. Synonyms are commanding, grand, grandiose, imperial, magnificent, massive, monumental, noble, ominous, stately, striking, towering. Adjective as in much, enough. I see. Come on, I gotta think of something for this. How do I end the night? How am I gonna nickname you? I gotta end the night with a good nickname for you. Think. Antlions are a group of about 2,000 species of insect in Neuropteran family Merimelion today. They are known for their predatory habits of their larvae, which mostly dig pits to trap passing ants or other prey. In North America, larvae are sometimes referred to as doodle bugs because of the marks they leave in the sand. The adult insects are much less well known due to the relatively short lifespans compared to the larvae. Adults, sometimes known as antlion lacewings, mostly fly at dusk or just after dusk and may be mistakenly identified as dragonflies or damselflies. Lacewing is a pretty cool name. I like it. You may not be shiny, but you're exactly what I wanted to build. We now have Lacewing on the team. And, well, I sincerely hope I'll be able to put them to good use. So the idea is going to be first turn Terrestrialize Dragon Dance, and then after that, boom, 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 with everything else. They have Levitate, which means they don't have to worry about particular spike and arena traps, only Stone Edge, which they'll already be out for. The idea is have them out, sweep. They should be able to tank the first hit in combat, regardless, since they'll terrestrialize. And anyone who expects to get it out with an ice type will, or dragon type or fairy type, will have a bad time. In addition to that, they're viable in doubles if I have a flying type or another levitator. Yeah, I think I have a strategy to work out with these guys. Yeah, so these two can U-turn and volt switch all day to swap in between each other, depending on what I'm facing off against. You know, alternations and shit like that. And I can still freely earthquake around them without any real drawback. I like it. Yeah. I'm gonna have fun working with them. Oh, wait. Right. Okay, they're fine then. Well, I'm just gonna quickly look up Zapdos' stats. Just to make sure I know what kind of speed I'm looking for. If its speed's high enough, I won't use a choice. Scarf, anyway. Both have 100 speed and it's maxed out, so they're actually just as fast as one another. It's a coin flip for them. Well, actually, the Zapdos is technically faster at base. Has a higher BST, though. Yeah, the Galarian Zapdos has a higher BST, definitely. It's very significantly noticeable. Oh, jeez. The BST of 580. It has 80 more on top of the Flygon. So they'll actually be a pretty good opening for doubles, which there's a lot of doubles around here. I think I'll enjoy using them. You're maxed out. You just need a whole bunch of bottle caps. Which I only have one. Unfortunate. Trigger 7 boosts the holder's attack stat, but only allows the use of a single move. Yeah, if the matchup is bad, I'm just gonna U-turn immediately. Punish physical attackers with pain. have to figure out what I want to make you into as a Terra type, though. You, it doesn't matter what I make you into. You'll have leftovers and levitate. I meant to say levitate and not leftovers at all, really. But you'll have both, technically. Yeah, we'll find a way to make it work. Anyways, I have been idling on for much too long. I need to go to bed, and I thank you all for watching. Please like, follow, favorite, subscribe, or whatever platform you have been watching on. And remember, hats off to you. It's late, and I know I got work tomorrow. So, have a good one, everybody.